as they're going down.
Okay.
sunshine. Special welcome to those who are visiting us. Thank you for bringing the sun. We hope you'll stay and let it all continue. There will be coffee in the hall after Mass if you're able to stay and share some poetry. We're offering today's Mass the repose of the soul of Isobel Ellis. Isobel was one of our most faithful members of the congregation and died about a year ago at this time. So we pray for her, for the repose of her soul, and for her family who still mourn for her. First, friends, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to the Father and to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you heal the wounds of our sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you intercede for us with the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Wisdom. I pray an understanding given. her silver ranks as mine. I loved her more than health or beauty, preferred her to the light, since her radiance never sleeps. In her company, all good things came to me, at her hands, riches not to be numbered. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give us for your love that we may rejoice.
Give us for your love that we may rejoice.
May we see the shortness of our life, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Lord, relent. Is your anger forever? Show pity to your servants.
Give us for your love that we may rejoice.
In the morning, fill us with your love. We shall exult and rejoice all days. Give us joy to balance our affection for the years when we knew of misfortune.
Let us give your love that we may rejoice.
Send forth your work to your servants. Let your glory shine on their children. Let the favour of the Lord be upon us. Give success to the work of our hands.
Let us give your love that we may rejoice.
Reading from the letter to the Hebrews. The word of God is something alive and active. It cuts us like any double-edged sword, but more finely. It can slip through the place where the soul is divided from the spirit, or joints from the marrow. It can judge the secret emotions and thoughts. No created thing can hide from him. Everything is uncovered and open to the eyes of the one to whom we must give account of ourselves. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus was setting out on a journey when a man ran up, knelt before him and put this question to him. Good Master, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Jesus said to him, why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. You must not kill. You must not commit adultery. You must not steal. You must not bring false witness. You must not defraud. Honour your father and mother. And he said to him, Master, I've kept all these from my earliest days. Jesus looked steadily at him and loved him. And he said, there is one thing you lack. Go and sell everything you own and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come, follow me. But his face fell at these words. And he went away sad, for he was a man of great wealth. Jesus looked round and said to his disciples, how hard it is for those who have riches to enter the kingdom of God. The disciples were astounded by these words. But Jesus insisted, my children, he said to them, how hard it is to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to pass through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. They were more astonished than ever. In that case, they said to one another, who can be saved? Jesus gazed at them. For men, he said, it is impossible, but not for God, because everything is possible for God. Peter took this up. What about us? He asked him. We have left everything and followed you. Jesus said, I tell you solemnly, there is no one who has left house, brothers, sisters, father, children, or land for my sake and for the sake of the gospel, who will not be repaid 100 times over, houses, brothers, sisters, mothers, children, and land, not without persecution, now in this present time, and in the world to come, eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Friends, I have good news and bad news. The good news is there is no homily this morning. The bad news is I have a letter from the bishop to read instead. It is a pastoral message to be read in all our churches over this weekend, and it concerns the synod, which is to take place in Rome in 2 years' time. If you listen to the Sunday program on Sunday mornings, you will have heard mention of it there. This is what our bishop writes. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this weekend the Holy Father will open a 2-year synodal journey of consultations and discernment in order that the Church can engage everyone in being more missionary. There are 3 phases: diocesan, continental, and universal, which will culminate with a gathering in Rome in October 2023. I want to share some reflections on the diocesan phase of this process. Synod, which comes from the Greek word synodos, which literally means walking together. This dimension of our church life asks, how is this journeying together happening in our situation? What steps does the Holy Spirit invite us to take to grow in this journeying together so that we can reach out to our brothers and sisters more effectively, that they too may be part of this journey with us? As the Lord reminds us in today's Gospel, everything is possible for God. All else in life fades away, knowing that we are accompanied by our Lord and Saviour. He desires that we find the path to his kingdom and that we assist one another along the way. To be focused on him is our main priority. We want others who don't know him to join us on this journey with him and through his kingdom. Our diocese has already started its synodal journey through some discussions and individual and parish submissions made through the process that we've started calling a precious place of God's grace. That was something we started just before lockdown and has gone on in a very stilted way, but will now start again with more vigour. And this remains a key point of reference for us here. We will dovetail what's being asked of us by Rome with listening carefully to what's being said locally. And the Holy See encourages this. A listening phase of the synodal journey will take place during Advent. Each parish will receive resources to facilitate this listening in our local communities so that everyone has an opportunity for their voice to be heard. The aim is to foster as broad a consultation as possible, reaching out to integrate the voice of the poor and the excluded, as well as engaging those who have any role or responsibility within the local parish. There will be both in-person and online opportunities to gather and reflect, as well as opportunities to make personal contributions through a dedicated email. I'm not going to give you an email address because you aren't going to write it down, but the whole thing, the letter is available. It's on at the back where the homily would normally be. Please do take it home so that you can look up references and emails and things like that. And the process will culminate in the diocesan pre-synodal meeting, or perhaps a couple of meetings in different parts of the diocese, early in 2022. the bishop says. I recognise that the timelines seem tight, but this will give us an opportunity to listen very deeply to one another in an ongoing process of consultation and discernment about our own future. This has already begun. It now needs fuller reflection, considering our local situations as well as the ongoing realities of living with COVID and all it means for our life of faith and witness. I will launch this listening phase of our walking together with a time of prayer in the cathedral at 4 p.m. next Sunday, the 17th of October. Anyone is welcome to attend. I don't think the bishop always realises just quite how long it takes to get from Helston to Plymouth. But of course, it will be online as well. All the cathedral services are broadcast online, so even if we can't get there, hopefully we can watch it and attend in spirit. I encourage you to fully engage with this important process in the life of the church, locally and universally, so that we can all be more effective missionary disciples. Very important is our prayer to the Holy Spirit, so that we listen to what God is saying to us, as well as listening deeply to what we are saying to one another. May the Holy Spirit guide us on this journey together and give us a share in God's wisdom and understanding. Pray for me, yours devotedly, Mark O'Toole, Bishop of Plymouth. Each community within our parish of Falmouth will have representatives who will encourage us as a congregation to go forward on this journey, to talk to one another, to remind us of the meetings, whether we meet together during Advent or whether we meet online for bigger discussions among bigger groups. Jane is going to be coordinating the representatives for us here in Helston. I only was told on Tuesday that we had to find representatives and their names had to be in by Friday. So everything is happening very fast. That's why it's happening this Advent, so that we can get to grips with it. The diocesan bit finishes in February next year. So we'll have to finish those consultations that we want to send for larger discussion within the European councils of bishops by February. Then I say it's discussed within Europe, and then it goes to Rome for universal discussion, worldwide discussion in October 2023. So the Pope is saying he wants to listen to what we have to say. So it's important what we want to say about the future of the church, about our working together to build the church, about us being missionary disciples. We need to listen to what the Spirit is saying to us. We need to listen to each other and then share those thoughts and pass them on up the line, as it were, to where they will be taken and considered further in this great consultation. So please do take a copy of the letter. Look at it carefully at home, follow up the web links and the emails, and join in this process. It would be great if we could all take part in it. I have a very funny feeling that some kind person turned off the amplifier earlier in the week when they were tidying up. So excuse me for a moment, because I don't seem to be, the speakers don't seem to be working. I thought it was just the battery that had failed, but
it wasn't the battery. Ah, here we are lying. Some kind of person said that pretty well wrong switch, put on a different switch, which doesn't get normally get turned off. So I hope everybody can hear me now. If you miss anything at the beginning, then my apologies. And my apologies too that it's quite cold. The part for the heating system still hasn't arrived. We hope it will before the sun disappears or is deserted. Friends, would you please stand as we join together in professing our faith? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnated with the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with his scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the lost to come. Amen. At the end of our bidding prayers, there is a special prayer that we've been asked to say for the sick. Friends, God fulfills all our needs and is the source of everything we have and all that we are. We ask him to listen to our prayers.
We pray that the Church may proclaim the example of Christ through its leaders and all Christians to encourage the world to seek love, truth, peace and justice. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray, thanking God for the beauty of creation, and pray that all people will respect and protect the world God created. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for refugees and the homeless. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those in prison and their families. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who have died recently and our own departed loved ones. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We join our prayers with Mary, the Mother of God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
For a few moments of silence, now let us bring our own prayers before the Lord.
God our Father, may we respond to your Son's call to follow him. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And the prayer for the sinner. We stand before you, Holy Spirit, as we gather together in your name. With you alone to guide us, make yourself at home in our hearts. Teach us the way we must go and how we are to pursue it. We are weak and sinful. Do not let us promote disorder. Do not let ignorance lead us down the wrong path, nor partiality influence our actions. Let us find in you our unity, so that we may journey together to eternal life, and not stray from the way of truth and what is right. All this we ask of you who are at work in every place and time, in the communion of the Father and the Son, forever and ever.
Amen.
saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Oh. righteousness.
Never permit me
to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. We entreat your majesty, most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us sharers of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
I seem to be apologizing for lots of things this morning. Mary's husband had a slight accident last night, which is why Mary, Miles, is not with us this morning, and so there is no children's liturgy. So my apologies to our young folks for that. Ian von Stock's server is in Trillis Hospital, so please keep Ian in your prayers. He took home the bells and the incense boat to clean last Sunday, and so they are still in his house, which is why we have an old bell and a strange incense boat this morning. Nobody's fault, but these things happen, so we make do as we can. If there are any more CAFOP envelopes to come back, please leave them on the table at the back. My thanks to everybody who helped make Thursday's celebration go with such a great success. It was lovely to see so many people here as we bless the new statue for the Lewis Grotto. If you haven't seen it, take a little walk around the back of the church before you go home and see the new statue in her place this morning. Although we carried her there, she is now cemented in, so you can't take her away with you, I'm afraid. Anything I forgot? Do take a copy of the bishop's letter if you would like. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Go and proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We end with the anthem of Wally.
Hail, Hail your Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you we cry, blessed children of Eve. To you we send our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, your eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary,
pray for us, the Holy Mother of God.
Thank you.
Thank you. congregationally, that's my, you know.
How should they,
they can pick up easy melodies. Generally, their music books do not have music. So that when they...
But it's one of those ones, I think, that, you know, we just do at the end of masking. You know what I mean? When we're going to introduce new hymns or music, if we do it at the end, then they can sort of like
hear it
subconsciously.
Yeah.
And then they need that realizing, which is like this.
I've asked him at the end several times. No, don't worry about putting them back. Do you think just the top, just so it doesn't bang them? Just the top. Something, you know, if I ask her to play